Now look here, don't get any ideas. I tell you the tech news, not the other way around.
Did you know that Google? No!
No, I tell the tech news.
Only you.
Today, Samsung officially unveiled the Galaxy S21, S21 Plus, and S21 Ultra, all powered by the new Qualcomm Snapdragon 888 system on a chip. And just like the leaks foretold in the before time, the S21 Ultra has two telephoto cameras for up to 100 times hybrid zoom, and it doesn't come with a charger in the box, even after Samsung just made fun of Apple for doing the same thing. Classic Samsung.
We're gonna jump off a bridge next.
You love to see it. What you don't love to see is the lack of a microSD card slot. You will have to be content with the onboard storage, although Samsung has slashed the prices of the whole S21 lineup by $200, with the vanilla S21 starting at $799. If you still need to spend that $200 on Wisely though, you can get the also just announced Galaxy Buds Pro, which feature active noise cancellation and, thankfully, aren't shaped like an ingredient from your mama's classic chili recipe.
It'll taste good.
Wait, what's unwise about that? They look pretty good. Samsung also announced smart tag Bluetooth trackers and an OLED display for laptops that will accommodate under display cameras. Although the mock-up did still have the camera at the top of the screen. What's the point unless I can look people in the eye over Zoom and assert my dominance, right? Like I'm doing with you right now.
You're supposed to say that to
2020 may have sucked for most people, but it was actually pretty great for computers. Research firm IDC, I love that they're called IDC, said that after almost a decade of declining sales, global shipments of PCs went up by 13% last year compared to 2019, giving the industry the biggest boost since 2010. People have been buying PCs to work from home, that obviously contributed, but you know what, gamers? You helped too. Steam released statistics showing that 21% more games were purchased in 2020 and 50% more gaming hours were logged. So it's no wonder that 2020 also tied 2016 for the warmest year on record, with our gaming rigs running full blast the whole time. Honestly, I think it's time we talked about gamer-related climate change. Actually, no, forget it, IDC. And a leaked build of Windows 10X has hit the web, giving tinkerers the opportunity to test out Microsoft's latest attempt at a lighter, cloud-focused version of the operating system. Lighter and cloud-focused.
Yeah.
You know, it sounds like kind of like Chrome OS.
Chromus.
And it looks like Chrome OS, too. The taskbar, app drawer, and quick settings panel all have eerily similar designs to the one you'd find on a Chromebook, and if that wasn't enough to ruffle your Windows enthusiast feathers, you can't sign in with a local account. It is Microsoft accounts only. It's unclear how Microsoft expects Windows 10X to succeed where previous light versions like Windows 10S and Windows RT have failed, but hey, sometimes you just gotta look at what's failed in the past and go, you know what? I'm gonna do that again.
Come on.
And the confidence will come, thus the beard. That's the punchline, but I didn't say the rest of the joke,
Hilarious.
So it makes no sense. Now time for the Clickety Clacks, brought to you by Pulseway, the service that lets you spend quality time with your devices, even when you're apart from them. Pulseway knows that being away from your remote systems and servers can be so hard for you emotionally, but with their real-time remote monitoring and management app that's compatible with Windows, Mac, and Linux, Pulseway gives you access to real-time status, system resources, logged-in users, network performance, Windows updates, and more. You can deploy custom scripts and update all your systems on the go, so it'll feel like your machines are right where you want them to be, safe in your arms. Rekindle your connections today by trying Pulseway for free at pulseway.com or through the link below. Clickety clacks, and they don't stop clacking to the rhythm of the boogie the beat. What the are we talking about here? We've already heard that Intel was considering outsourcing chip production to other manufacturers, but a new report from TrendForce claims that they've already begun giving contracts to TSMC to produce some non-CPU chips. The report also claims TSMC will begin mass production of 5-nanometer Core i3 CPUs later this year, and 3-nanometer Core i5 and i7s next year. Dang! Pat Gelsinger moves fast.
Got right to work. Sorry, Bob Swan.
Amazon smart home company Ring exposed the precise locations and home addresses of people who had posted in the Ring Neighbors app, which was designed to allow users to post anonymous alerts about nearby crime and public safety issues. It's only the latest security flub for the company, which just added end-to-end encryption this week in an attempt to repair their reputation. Sounds like this is one Ring that needs to be thrown into the fires of Mount Doom. Ah, and you guys want a Carpool Critics plug.
Yeah.
They're doing Return of the King. You can go subscribe.
Go back to the shadow.
The New York Times has published a fascinating and horrible story about owners of Bitcoin wallets who have lost access to a collective $140 billion worth of cryptocurrency. One guy has 220 million worth of Bitcoin in his wallet, but he forgot his password and has used up 8 of the 10 attempts that the wallet will allow before it locks forever. Wow. That is, imagine having $220 million in like a safe that explodes if you try to.
Yeah. It could kill you.
Nintendo is issuing copyright claims on videos that show people hacking the company's latest Game & Watch portable console. But they're only doing so on videos that show the consoles playing Nintendo games, like, after the hacking, which just makes me think Nintendo is confused. Or maybe they're just not confused. Maybe they just want everyone to hate them. Maybe that's the plan.
Do it.
Nintendo's secret plan.
See if I care.
And speaking of hated, EA wants to make sure that you know that Ubisoft has not taken their favored spot as the Star Wars game developer. The publisher tweeted that they are making more Star Wars games than anyone has ever made before, and more importantly, they're gonna have more loot boxes for those Star Wars games than you can even imagine. Actually, that's not fair. They have gotten better. Squadrons doesn't have any loot boxes, and Squadrons is like pretty sick.
Yeah, so, you love that game.
Yeah, yeah, it's actually really cool.
Did you play it now?
I haven't played it off hours yet, but it's very cool. Yeah. This episode won't be good though if it keeps going, so it's over. Come back tomorrow for more tech news, and maybe even the next day.
Tech news forever.
Saturday tech news?
It's tech
Saturday?
News for a million years.
A million years tech news. No, there's no tech news on Saturday.